All right, we're open for questions. Front row, Heather. Heather.
Jason Lloyd, The Athletic. LeBron, the MVP voting came out a couple minutes before the tip tonight, and wondering if you saw those results that you were not in the top three, and if that fit into the game at all, and whether or not you even saw your reaction not being in the top three.
No, I didn't see it. And what you gonna do about it at the end of the day? I mean, my only job is to try to be the MVP for this team every night, put our franchise in position to be successful, and ultimately compete for a championship, though. So for me, I know what I bring to the table. This league knows what I bring to the table, so it's for you guys to write about. It's not for me to be concerned about it.
Joe.
Joe Varden, Cleveland.com. Before the playoffs, you said you thought that you had enough to win a championship this year. What are you seeing from your team now, 10 straight? And obviously tonight's game was what it was. Where do you see this team right now?
We just want to try to get better. I also told you we had another level. And you looked at me crazy when I told you that. I believe we got another level as well. As well as we played tonight, there were still some things we could have did better. We had a few bad turnovers offensively that we could do better. We had a couple miscues defensively where we gave us some open looks. So we can just continue to we can get better. And that's a positive for our ball club. And, it's no complacency with us right now. I mean, it shouldn't be. It's the postseason. But we like where we're headed in the direction we're headed right now.
Dave.
David Greneman, ESPN. LeBron, even before the series started, Brad Stevens said that he felt like the Cavs had a perfect roster. That was before you were up 28 in game one, before you were up 50 in game two. What do you feel about the roster composition and the pieces that you have and what you are potentially able to accomplish with them?
Well, I mean, that's a huge compliment, but there's no such thing for us. We don't have a perfect roster. We don't have a perfect team, but we can make up for mistakes, and we can make up for some deficiencies that we may have because we communicate, we fly around, and we sacrifice one another. So, that could put us as close to perfection as possible, which you can't ever get to. But, our communication level, our sacrifice, what we give to each other every night, kind of covers that, kind of covers some of the faults that we may have. And with the faults that we do have, we try to get better and better at it. So we could be as great as we can be every single night.
Middle right. You.
Jake Fisher with Sports Illustrated. LeBron, you said this team had another level, but now you've won 13 straight games in the postseason. Is this the highest level that you've played offensively in your career?
I don't know. I'm a guy who lives in the moment, and our team is in a great groove, and I'm happy to be a part of that groove. So, at the end of the day, we want to try to put ourselves in position to win every game. That's the goal. And can you do that? Sometimes you come out with an L, but it's how you learn from those experiences that's going to help you off the next time. So we are in a good groove as a team, and we want to try to continue that going home.
That's that.
LeBron, Tom Lydon, Boston 25 News to your left here. Isaiah sat out the second half. Brad told us before he came out here that he's been dealing with an injury since last week. Can you sense something physically different with him through these first two games?
I don't pay attention to those things, to be honest. I only pay attention to what's going on with our guys and how we can put, a lot of pressure on the opposing team. From IT to the rest of those guys. So, obviously we didn't see him in the second half. Marcus Smart started the second half, but, that was not our concern going into the second half. Our concern was not get complacent. Don't do what we did, in game one in the third quarter here where we gave up, I think, 36 or something points, in that quarter and allowed him to get into a good groove. So, it's not my concern.
Jared Weiss, CLNS Media Network. Do you feel like with your physical perimeter defense, you guys have kind of pushed them out of their comfortable game plan and kind of put their backs against the wall at this point?
Well, they're going to make another adjustment. and we have to be ready for that going into game three. We're going to watch film tomorrow and see ways we can be better. We do have some great perimeter defenders that takes the challenge, but we also have great third line defense as well, you know, with our front line who communicates, you know, pick and roll coverages or pin down coverages or whatever coverages that's going on that allow the guards to get up into the ball or, you know, do what they need to do to be successful versus their guards.
Bob Schron, the Citizen. LeBron, Brad was saying one of the takeaways he took from the game was in the beginning of the fourth quarter, Kyle, a bunch of the veterans were out there, RJ, playing so professionally. Are you guys at a point where you're challenging each other, you know, excellent veterans, making each other better?
Well, absolutely. We had a veteran ball club. One of the oldest teams in the league, so we all push each other. We're here for one reason. When you sign up to be here, we're here to compete. We're here to sacrifice for one another. And if you're in garbage time or if you're in the crunch time, you need to be a professional. And, you know, RJ's done that. Champ has done that. Channing is doing that. You see guys playing one round that has a huge, a huge piece for one round. But then the next round, you know, certain things change. And guys just continue to stay ready. Guys just continue to stay professional. And it's great to be in the locker room like that.
Anything else? Derek, thank you.